In this screencast, we will compare different clustering algorithms using CuriosityIT. First, I select the 5 clusters dataset from the main menu and look at it in the scatterplot viewer. We see that this dataset indeed contains 5 clusters. I now choose the color from groups option above, and then I select the k-means algorithm, and I select, for instance, 3 clusters. Then, of course, the algorithm will give me 3 clusters, which means for this algorithm, you have to specify the number of clusters it should generate. It will not find automatically the exact number of clusters. And if I put 3 and the dataset has in fact 5 clusters, then 2 clusters are put together into 1, which is not what we want. If we put the exact cluster numbers, we get the proper result with the 5 clusters. If we choose more, like 7 clusters, then some clusters, like the one on top and the red gray here, are split into 2 clusters. Very similar results we get when we choose the self-organizing maps clustering. Here I have a 3.3 self-organizing map grid, which is 9 clusters. In this case, we get 6 clusters. The reason for that is that 3 clusters are in fact empty. This one here, this one here, and here is a 1. Also, with the self-organizing maps clustering, you have to specify the number of clusters or the dimensions of the SOM grid. So how can we find out how many clusters there are in the dataset? For this, we need a visualization. We look at distances of the cluster centers. For instance, with this visualization, the distance matrix is dimension reduced and visualized on this surface. And here, let's choose the k-means algorithm with 9 clusters. And we see that some clusters are very close together, here in the middle, on the right side, and in front. And this means that these 3 clusters form, in fact, 1 large cluster. These 2 form 1 cluster, and these 2 form 1 cluster. And from this kind of visualization, you can determine the exact cluster size. There is another method to analyze cluster structure of a dataset. We can use the self-organizing maps U-matrix viewer. And here we see we have 1 cluster here with a light green, another cluster here, 1 cluster here, 1 cluster here, and 1 last cluster here. And you can see quite well that the clusters are typically separated by hills, which means large distances in the U matrix. Here also we have hill, they separate these 2 clusters. These 2 clusters are separated here by a hill, and they're usually empty self-organizing map cells. So here you can see quite well that the dataset has in fact 5 clusters. These 2 here, the hill is missing, which is probably because there were simply not enough self-organizing map cells to visualize this properly, so it's not always perfect. Another method to detect clusters is the density viewer. We will look at the 2 close dataset, which contains 2 clusters which are quite close together. And if we look at this in the density viewer, we get some wild structure where we don't see much. But when we start to reduce the visible data points to the densest area, we clearly see the cluster structure. If we go further back, we see really very well where we have the densest areas in the data set. Let's have a look now at some density-based clustering methods. We choose again the 5 clusters dataset, which we have used before. And let's choose here dbScan. And we see that this algorithm is also able to find the five clusters. Here in the parameters, we did not specify the number of clusters, so the algorithm finds that out by itself. And let's see at the moons dataset, which looks like this in the scatterplot viewer, is a two-dimensional dataset. We could, in fact, here make that a little bit simpler. And if we use now, choose here the dbscan method and correct parameter for epsilon, we see that dbscan is indeed able to separate these two half moons. Now let's see how we can use clustering together with dimension reduction. We choose the two closed dataset, which looks like this. We have a small cluster and a large cluster, which are quite close together. And to see what, to compare the effect of the clustering with the effect of the dimension reduction, we first have to add a category, which means, for instance, we choose here k-means with three clusters. We add a category. What happens now, if we go to the table, we see that we have an additional column, which contains the cluster number for each record. I go back to the scatterplot viewer, and now I choose dimension reduction to two dimensions, from three to two. And we see that the T-SNE algorithm is in fact capable of finding these two clusters. And now to compare it to the cluster K-means clustering, we go to groups, but we don't select here K-means because this is clustering the dimension reduced data set. We choose here the category we created before, here the K-means clustering. And now we see that this worked quite well. There are some red data points here which should be put in this cluster probably. And we also see that the clustering algorithm created three clusters as we requested. But otherwise this worked quite well.